Welcome back to Evil Deedz, episode 5 of L.A.Noire. And we are still on the famous idol chapter. I just did fast travel. That's all I do. So it's a silver skate or something. Fire roof or top.
Keep him here, Stefan. I'm gonna take a look around.
What's this got to do with me? Don't try my patience, knucklehead.
No vibration. As you can see, there's a camera.
Huh. Oh, wow. Find a way into that peep tent, Phelps. I'll stay here and keep our pervert company. Can't be that way, Phelps. Couldn't fit a rat through that.
So it's about that same person. Whatever you call it. Psychiatrist. If you want me to do a playthrough of a game for Xbox 360, just put in suggestions in the comments below.
And I have to call you back. I got some business here.
Sit down, Courtney. This is Mickey. Mickey, this is Courtney Sheldon. What would you like to drink?
Scotch. Straight up. I hear you're back at school learning to be a doctor, kid.
Yes. That's right, Mr. Cullen.
You want to be a doctor and a dope peddler. fancy combination, huh?
Do we have a problem, Mr. Carr?
We might have. Yeah. Selling your dope to my boy Lenny looked like a good move, but Lenny has been supplying, wholesale, so to speak. The Bindle boys in this town aren't used to the juice, but I'm little the middleman taking his cut.
Lenny promised that wouldn't happen, Mr. Carr. And Lenny works for you.
What can I say about Lenny? Wait, babe. Oh, yeah, he's a putz. And he's lazy, and he's greedy, but he's my wife's brother. You have to make a cake with those ingredients, huh? Please.
So how is that my problem, Mr. Cohen?
Well, kid, the only way we're going to be able to make this work is to do some repackaging. We need to get the dope out of those dinky little cardboard boxes as serrettes. Yeah, serrettes. Great. Put into a big vat and water it down a little.
I won't bore you with the chemistry, but it doesn't work that way. You're likely to kill even more people.
Okay, listen. We want to buy you out, dude. I'll offer you $50,000. Hey. Hey! You don't like my offer? Sheldon, kid? I think I want him dead.
Now back to the game. That twist beats.
Jungle Drums, 8th and Francisco. Attention, Mark Bishop.
Some more drink.
So what happened to the fellow of Hamilton screen test?
To be tall at the... Oh, there's... Remember, there's a mirror there as well. So he's been spying on people whilst they've been peeing. And same with the mirrors. See if there's anything over here. Nope, nothing.
You ever do any work for Mark Bishop?
Mainly do work for the studios. RKO, Republic, Warner Brothers. So yeah, when Bishop was doing work for a studio.
Yes. When did you last see him?
Now I'm doing work for his next picture. Still pre-production though. I haven't seen him around here in a while.
So that's a lie.
I know you're lying, Hopgood. Bishop was here and you know exactly what he was doing and what he left lying around afterwards.
You come in here without a warrant and now you start throwing your weight around?
And then it's some kind of jokes. Where is it?
Not one.
Yep.
15-year-old girl told me how she was drugged and molested at a casting house. I found the chloral hydrate in your drinks cabinet. You give me something or I will break your fucking jaw, Hopgood.
Bishop was here with June Belling and the girl. A lot of producers and directors use this place. I'm not responsible for what goes on here.
McAfee's men are looking for Bishop. We need to find him first. Any idea where he might have gone aground?
If he really tried to kill McAfee's wife, my advice to him would be to leave town.
This is the truth.
You're delivering props to Jungle Drums on 8th Street?
Bishop is using that old rundown wreck of a set. That place is dangerous. But it might be a good spot to hide.
What's the deal with you and June Ballard?
Look, buddy, I make props. I hardly ever meet the talent unless it's something tailor-made for them, like a...
This
sword.
One's a lie.
You and Ballard are blackmailing Bishop. That's
and
why
it was the empty reel.
You got nothing on me. My hands are clean on this.
Where is it? Not that one. It's this one, the empty one. Empty film canister.
Enough. I've been in your peep room, Hopgood. I've seen your smut pictures in the camera setup. You made a movie of Jessica. I found the canister.
The deal is I get to sell the movies to burlesque houses and private collectors. These movie guys love seeing their cocks on screen. But part of the arrangement is I never film their faces. June had me film Bishop. And then she kept the movie for insurance. Went apeshit when he realized his face was front and center.
Who has the film now?
Who else? McAfee.
Now this one's a lie, the evidence of blackmail.
Ballard had what she wanted. Where's the money come into it?
What money?
And it is the check. 20,000 check.
I told you, I get my cut selling dirty movies.
This one here. Check for 20,000 made out to Lorna Hopgood on the account of Mark Bishop.
Your ex was getting 20 large from Bishop.
If I wanted to skim 20 from Bishop, we'd do it through the movie budget. June said she'd sell him the film once the movie had wrapped, but guy wanted cash. He's in a cash-only business. You think I had a choice in this?
That's all for now, Hopgood. We're taking you in.
Spells! Roy Earl, add vice. Hold on a moment. This is clearly a vice case. You've been roughing up my informant?
Hopgood is a vice informer?
Yes, he is, Phelps, and a very important one. Look at that mug. Have you been upsetting these two officers, Marlin?
So we just drop it?
You do if you know what's good for you. You need to catch the movie producer before an angry husband does, from what I'm hearing.
I'll be making a full report to the captain, detective.
You do that, kid. We're all very impressed with you. Let it slide, Cole. Let's get out of here.
Detectives!
Johnny Goldberg. You work for Mickey C.
That's right, detectives.
You wouldn't happen to know the guys who roughed up Mrs. Bishop earlier today, by any chance?
No, no. Not us. We don't do that kind of thing. It's the husband we'd like to talk to.
This is a police matter. You don't want to be taken in for obstruction of justice, do you, boys?
you could try the obstruction rap, but it won't stick. We can beat that.
You've had your 10 cents worth, gentlemen.
Bishop knows how the world works. Mrs. McAfee hits him up for a movie part. Happens every day. But Bishop takes it a step too far and tries to rub out Mrs. McAfee. Naturally, Guy is going to get upset.
What made you think Bishop would be here?
We figure he might be planning a little accident for Hopgood, too. Those two guys have got some unfinished business. You let us know if you find Bishop. Guy McAfee can be a very generous man.
I'm only going to warn you once, gentlemen. Stay out of this. This is a police matter. We will be bringing Mark Bishop into custody.
At least he's polite. Kind of dumb. But polite.
But I'm a lot less polite than smug son of a bitch. So let me put it in ruder terms that even a pair of blockheads like you might understand. The only reason that you don't have bars on your windows already is because you're small fry. And we don't waste our time on small fry. You stay away from Bishop, and you stay away from me. Is that clear? Now run along back to your boss so we can pat you on the head and tell you what good boys you are.
Gotta turn it down because I got a copyright notice by the music on the car playing. Don't know why, but yeah. So I'm gonna turn it down for this bit. The reason why I don't want to get a copyright notice is because then I can't monetize the video, so I can't put ads onto it.
There's a slippery bastard now. No. God damn it!
Mark Bishop, stop! L.A.P.D. Get him, Phelps. I'll cover the exit.
Seems to run slow when he goes onto the stairs. I know he runs upstairs like that anyway. He normally do little steps, like he jog kind of thing. This is where the game changes. A slight bit quite anomalous.
Hey,
Tricks, and I'll save McCaffey's boys the trouble.
Follow me. I know another way out of this place.
So they're down on the ground and we're up in the air. Watch this.
Christ, detectives are trying to kill me.
Fair enough. The aim is not like this. He's on that scaffold.
They're everywhere.
Why is it like that? Whatever.
Sissy instead of sticking with the little girls. That is justice. Capital J, Detective Phelps. Built such a reputation, I'm not going to be able to hold on to you any longer. You're getting promoted. Go on, get your new assignment. It's good working with you.
Something? I'm here to buy a drink for the two LAPD traffic cops who broke the back of Guy McCaffey's private army. You don't have a problem with that, do you, Captain?
It looks like one of them jackasses.
Go right ahead. Get in. I'm buying.
There's. Not the Steve one, but the one.
German junkie whore. Don't you ever forget your place with me again. Do you hear me? Evening, Doc. How's business? Sanguine. Louis, come to you.
Is this a psychiatrist?
Blow it off.
All the newspapers talk about.
Meet Dr. Harlan Fontaine, doctor to the stars. Mr. Fix-It to the mental wreckage of Hollywood. So what about that drink, boys?
The third degree. Complete all cases on the traffic desk. Currently branch every question and every interview in a single story case. Changes will stick to Mr. and Mrs. McAfee, but Mark Bishop's film career is officially over. Promoted homicide desk. Six months later. Your blood won't do that. 46 Park, it only 2290, is that? Or is that a free beginning? Pacific Electric.
All right, gentlemen, take your seats. Let's get this over before lunch. Clyde Rose of the Homicide Squad has decided to take early retirement. We will all miss Floyd and the steely edge she brought to this police work. The department has arranged a wee drink at the Galway Arms to quench the mighty thirst a man gets from 25 years of police work. Floyd's departure leaves a place at the top table, and the chief has seen fit to promote Cole Phelps from burglary to the homicide desk. Stand up, Phelps. Take a chair. You're in the major leagues now, sonny. Rusty Galloway, the fine lawman of the old school, will be taking you under his wing. Your first case is the murder of a woman, found last night and bearing all the signs of the werewolf. Get out to the scene, lads.
So I'm guessing all of these will become a partner eventually. So let's have a look at these. Is that all partner?
Kermit Salter. Printer by trade.
Tell me today. What do you think? Too many
self-cameras. Now it's a different car.
You have the address.
Been all over KGPL. Off Temple Street, between Belmont and Glendale.
Turn that now. Turn the radio. Options. Sound. No. Clue music. Music will automatically fade down when all clues in the location. Yeah. Action escape. Go on then. That's just progress. No. Can't turn that radio off.
What do you mean by the werewolf? The Daily News came out calling it a werewolf. The Examiner came up with a black job.
Any closer to catch me?
That's gonna kill us!
That's one way of turning it off.
Thank you.
of a loading screen. The Broadway Hollow Wonder. If any of you got the game of Monster Legends, you can always add me on Facebook at Evil Deedz.
I'll do it! So help me God, I'll jump!
You need to get up there. Let me do the talking, detective. I know a ton of this psychology stuff. Take the back alley and find a way up there.
Come on, Phelps, let's get moving.
What you wanted?
I can't do it. I'll go quietly. I need some help. Please. You gotta get me some help.
You're a danger to yourself and to others.
So this is going to be it for this episode. So I hope you enjoyed, but first I'm going to get this car.
Out of the car, police!
Are you being that?
He just refuses to accompany me to church.
LAPD, police emergency.
Be careful with it, copper!
Are you being that one? This is the worst collectible thing you can have in a game, for all cars, let's say. It's easy to forget which ones you've been in. There is 95 of different vehicles. And each one looks very similar. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Please leave a like, subscribe or comment down below if you want to, it's up to you, you don't have to. And in a bit.